In today's video, we're gonna talk about one of my favorite neighborhoods in Virginia Beach. It's called Middle Plantation, and it's in Little Neck, and we're starting right now. Hey, my name is Sam Sansalone, and I'm a real estate agent in the Hampton Roads area, anywhere from the south of Virginia Beach all the way up through Williamsburg, and I do videos every week about living and moving to the area. So if you have any questions about moving here or what it's like to live here, please let me know. I've got my contact information in the description. You can reach out to me anytime you'd like, and I will do whatever I can to help you. So in today's video, we're talking about what I think is one of the most often overlooked neighborhoods in Virginia Beach called Middle Plantation. So the question first is, what makes this area so interesting? We're gonna talk about all of that. The neighborhood, the school districts, the history, what I like about it, the drawbacks to living there, the real estate. We'll do some drive-throughs like I always do in these neighborhood videos. So, but first, where is Middle Plantation, Sam? You'll see on the eastern side of Virginia Beach, you have the ocean front. Well, to the central north section of Virginia Beach, there's this area called Little Neck. It's basically like a big cul-de-sac in Virginia Beach, real big, with lots of neighborhoods in it. Well, in that big cul-de-sac, you go, there's a long road going north, Little Neck Road, and on Little Neck Road, just past halfway up along this road, is to the right-hand side, is this neighborhood. Tucked away, you'll see a little sign that says Middle Plantation on it, and then through the trees is the whole neighborhood. It's close to a ton of stuff. So you're about 15 minutes away from the oceanfront Virginia Beach. You're also about 15 minutes away from a Shore Drive and Chicks Beach. And you're like 10 minutes away from Town Center of Virginia Beach. And because you're close to 264, about 15 to 17 minutes away from downtown Norfolk. Now bases, you're about 20 to 25 from Oceana. You're about 20 to 25 also from a Norfolk Navy base. You are super central. You're also not too close to the main roads to where you won't hear any traffic either. So it's got a lot of locational benefits to it. So what's the history like here? Well, it's not a real historic neighborhood in one sense. These houses were built in 10 stages going from the late 70s into the late 80s. So there's not a lot of like past history about these houses. But the name, Middle Plantation, well, where does that come from? If you see my video about Williamsburg, you know that Middle Plantation was the name of Williamsburg before it became Williamsburg in 1699. So that's where that name came from. Now for shopping, I mean, you're literally like 3 minutes away from Kroger, the closest grocery store, and across the street from there is Sam's Club, which I don't really do Sam's Club, I do Costco, but anyways, Harris Teeter is right there, there's a Home Depot right there. You literally have pretty much every shopping opportunity up and down that street called Virginia Beach Boulevard, which is the primary road that's on the very southern tip of Little Neck and goes all the way across the city. So that road, if you're close to that road, you can really hit anywhere from there within a reasonable amount of time, including interstates. You're close to Interstate 264. You're close to Alaskan Road, which has Hilltop, which has Trader Joe's, Whole Foods, lots of boutique shops along that section. It's closer to the ocean front. So shopping, it's got it in spades. Now, things to do in and around Middle Plantation. Well, the general idea about things to do here is you got the ocean front. People love the beach. We talked about that. We talked about, you know, all the, like, the Marine Science Museum. We're talking about the parks, the First Landing State Park in the northeastern corner of Virginia Beach. We've got plenty of parks all across Virginia Beach, but in the area of Middle Plantation, there's a park that's literally right down the street from Middle Plantation itself. It's right off of Little Haven Road, and there are a couple of other parks all throughout Little Neck too. Because Virginia Beach is so loaded with parks, this area does not disappoint with that. And as far as nature goes, you can walk around through the neighborhoods and it's so quiet. And also just outside of the neighborhood, right next to it, you could walk there, is the Little Neck Swim and Racquet Club. So you got tennis courts and a nice pool there right off of Little Neck Road. There, I'll drop the fees and the information about the costs associated with that below in the description. There are some cool events in this area too, namely because this neighborhood has an HOA and it's a very active HOA. And so there are community events throughout the year. 4th of July parade, they do an Easter egg hunt, they do a Halloween scavenger hunt. There's a women's club in Middle Plantation. And then down the street from May to September, they have a farmer's market. So local produce, local stuff, products, and then they've got food trucks often too. So that's throughout the summertime. That's literally down the street from Middle Plantation. I'll drop a link for the farmer's market too. Of course, in addition to that, you've got the town center area, the performing arts centers, more shopping, then you've got downtown Norfolk, about 20, 25 minutes away. So now next is the school districts. This is one of the biggest draws to this area as well, because this area has some of the highest ranked school districts in demand here in Virginia Beach, which is saying something. Number one is Kingston Elementary School, one of the highest ranked elementary schools in the city, and the most in demand, I'd say, of any place I have been to in the entire Hampton Roads area. The school that I've heard the most about that people keep wanting to go back to is Kingston Elementary School. Next is Lynn Haven Middle School, is also your middle school, and First Colonial High School is your high school, which is a bit far away, honestly, from Middle Plantation. It's about, I don't know, about 15 to 20 minutes or so. It actually is in Great Neck. And I'll drop links below for all the school districts here in the description below too. Now, of course, the fun part, the real estate. What are the houses like? What does it feel like in this area? What is it just like to live in Middle Plantation? Well, one of the things I love most about this neighborhood is that it has so many trees. Pine, oak, this is loaded. You see all like these big canopies. It really creates a nice setting in the neighborhood. Because once you go off the main road or off Virginia Beach Boulevard, you don't realize how thick and lush these areas are. And so when you see houses that are designed so well, mixed with a neighborhood that feels so nice, it's the perfect combination, which is what makes this so great. The streets are a little bit wider. I'd say that the houses are a little bit different, a little bit more set apart. The terrain in Middle Plantation is a little bit interesting too, because part of it is on the shoreline. There are some very subtle hills or some kind of drop-offs as you go off the shoreline. Real subtle stuff, but can make a big difference with how the area feels. Most of these houses are decent size. They're anywhere from like the 2,500 square feet to like around 4,000, but I've seen some higher than that in this area. Now you've got some on the water, which do run upwards of about anywhere from 850 to 9 upwards over $1 million. So once you get, you know, real well done, nice on the water. But the smaller ones, like the 25 to 3,000 square footers, they're in that $6,750 price range usually. So it kind of depends on what your preferences are, how big of a house you're looking for. But you can stay under $650, $700 in a lot of cases if you do want something a little bit smaller in size. Now, in general, houses in this neighborhood don't sell super frequently. I'd say about once every three-ish weeks or so, I think one would come up on the market. So if you do like this neighborhood and you want to go after it, I would say be ready for the house that you're looking for. But that's what makes Middle Plantation so cool too, is because you could be waiting for the neighborhood, but you never know what kind of house you're gonna get in the neighborhood because they're so unique. Everything is different, so you don't feel that cookie cutterness at all. Like, every spot feels different. So that can be good if you love that variety, but if you're looking for a very specific type of floor plan, that might be a little bit more difficult because many of the floor plans are so, so unique. You have a decent mixture of vinyl and brick houses, and not all of them feel like colonial style when you're looking at them. A lot of them are more traditional. But so while the house designs are unique, they do try to make it feel a little bit more colonial in just the general vibe of the neighborhood, even if not all the houses might feel exactly like something you'd get in Colonial Williamsburg. You'll even find some Cape Cod style houses in here. But these houses were built incredibly well. They have some designs that really are appealing, and a lot of them often accentuate the outdoors. And so because each lot is different, it can add to the uniqueness of the vibe. Now, that being said, because everything's so different, you will find some lots that do have a little bit more, like you'll see more hills in the back yard. You know, it might be more difficult to put pools in some cases just based on the shape of the lots. I'm not saying you can't, it's just that each lot might have its own uniqueness to it that might create some unique difficulties on the flip side. And you've got the water access on the eastern side of the area, and it eventually empties out into the Chesapeake Bay. So you can take a boat from your house if you're on the water and go all the way up to Shore Drive near Chicks Beach, all the way into the Chesapeake Bay. That being said, if you do live on water, this area is tidal. So just because you live on water doesn't mean it's going to stay the same height all the time. So to me, that can factor in if you do want waterfront, but you also want a big boat. Now, if you look in the overhead map, look at the satellite view, and you notice anywhere that there's dark green, you can see that there are more trees and densely populated trees. So if you look specifically at Virginia Beach, you'll notice that the place that has the most densely populated green, this big green splotch, is Little Neck. And if you do a zoom in, then you can look in and you see that on the eastern section of Little Neck, you'll see Middle Plantation. It's all a bunch of green, right? So this is very cool and unique compared to what you might find in a lot of places in Virginia Beach. Now, another benefit to this area is you don't have as much jet noise over here as well. Now, there will be times where you will hear some stuff. randomly. It's not super loud though. So I've talked about jet noise on all kinds of videos, and I say that as you get closer to the eastern section and as you go further south as well into Virginia Beach, you will hear lots of jet noise, and it can be piercing, it can be random, you don't hear it all the time, but it's pretty annoying and it's pretty loud in some spots. But if you go further north and west, that starts tapering off. And so Little Neck is right on the line to where you might notice it a little bit, but it probably won't be enough to really justify making decisions around the fact that you might be able to hear some of it. So you've got the accessibility. You don't have to deal with the jet noise. You've got the cool vibes of the houses. It checks so many boxes to me. So you've got the combination of big house and often a neat, decent sized lot. So if you're spending like the $750,000 to $800,000 price range, you're gonna be getting a lot for what you're paying for. I personally would much rather live in a house like this than I would spend $700,000 for new construction. It's in a cookie cutter neighborhood that has no uniqueness to it, that's not in the same style of area either. Now, the drawbacks to living in Middle Plantation. Well, number one is you're not super close to the main road. In one sense, it's convenient to lots of stuff. It'd be something to drive like 3, 4, or 5 minutes to get anywhere because you are tucked away in this big neighborhood in this like cul-de-sac in Little Neck. You have to drive out of the neighborhood and go around to go to other parts of the city, like in the northern parts. So that can be a drawback. Next one is the price. So, you know, if you do want something that is like under $500,000, this is not the place. So you're talking $700,000, $800,000, $900,000 for the most part in this area. It is a little bit higher in price than other parts of Virginia Beach. And next is in parts, you can have a little bit of jet noise, enough to at least know that it's there. And one of the benefits to this area is it's HOA, but the drawback is also it is in an HOA. So if you don't like HOAs, you might not like this neighborhood for the criteria and the guidelines you might have to abide by. Not saying it's super, super difficult, but at the same time, there are regulations. So I'm gonna drop a link for the Civic League, the Middle Plantation Civic League, so you can see if this HOA is something you might be interested in. So if you have any other questions about living or moving to Virginia Beach or the Hampton Roads area, if you wanna relocate into this area, please let me know. I'll do whatever I can to help you, and I will see you on the next video.